Let us continue our discussion about Jekta's form. Let us see how to find Jekta's form of some given signal. Jekta's form of some expression provided we know its region of convergence. So for that, let's consider a problem we have been given an expression for Z transform. X is equal to 1 upon 1 minus 1.5 Vm minus 1 plus 0.5 Vm minus 2. We have to find out what is the signal XL under the condition that ROC mod G is greater than 0.5. Second, XN when ROC is mod G less than 1. Third condition, what is the signal XN when ROC is mod G greater than 0.5? Less than 1. Now let's discuss the problem again. We have been given an expression XZ of Z transform. We have to find out what is the signal XZ corresponding to XZ under three conditions. One condition is ROC mod G greater than 0.5. The other condition is ROC mod G less than 1. The third condition is ROC is mod G greater than 0.5 and less than 1. Let us examine the condition. Let's try to find out what is signal XN corresponding to XN under the condition ROC mod Z greater than 0.5. Mod Z greater than 0.5, this indicates the region of convergence outside the circle. So this suggests, this ROC says that signal corresponding to XZ must be positive. So one point is clear, that this ROC suggests signal XZ corresponding to XZ as positive. Now how to determine the signal XZ? Look in the expression of XZ. This is the form numerator upon denominator. Denominator is a quadratic polynomial. So in general, we don't have any standard Z transform for a quadratic polynomial except for cosine and sine discrete time functions. That means for discrete time sinusoidal functions. So the simpler way of doing this, let us try to decompose XZ into first order expression, first order fractions. For that, let us see how to do it. 1 minus 1.5 Vm minus 1 plus 0.5 Vm minus 2. Let's factorize it. Let's factorize the denominator polynomial. So this becomes X of Z 1 upon 1 minus E square minus 0.5 1. Then 0.5 Vm minus 2. Then let's subscribe to the factor. So xz now becomes 1 upon 1 minus e inverse. I have taken these two terms. So let's take 0.5 e inverse has come from these two terms. So if I take 0.5 e inverse common, then for this I get 1 and I get here minus e raised to power minus 1. Now xz can be written as 1 upon 1 minus e inverse 1 minus 0.5 inverse. This is what is xz. Now, with the help of partial fraction, let us try to find out the simpler expression for xz. To do that, for partial fraction expression, what we aim is xz is equal to 1 minus e inverse 1 and then 1 minus 0.5 e inverse 1. What we write here? Now e upon and plus e upon, where e and b are constants. I am telling a much simpler method for doing partial fraction expansion, which corresponds to simple terms, that means terms without any multiplicity. What is required here? That what is the numerator of 1 minus e inverse? What is the numerator? And what is the numerator of 1 minus 0.5 e inverse? These are the two things which are required. To find out what is the numerator of this, let us cover this term. Covering this term means I am putting this to 0. This will be 0 only when the inverse is 1. When the inverse is 1, this term becomes 0, 1 minus 1 equal to 0. Now, let us put the inverse 1 in the rest of the expression and see what is left, what we obtain on it. The inverse 1, if I put the inverse 1 here, then this becomes 1 minus 0.5. That means 0.5. 1 upon 0.5 is 2. So its numerator becomes 2. You can do oral. Now, what is the numerator of this? So, you get that? Now, let us cover this. Covering this means I am putting this term as 0. This will be 0 only when this becomes 1. For this to become 1, the inverse must be 2. Because 2 in 0.5 is 1. So, let us put z inverse 2 in the rest of the expression. If I put z inverse as 2 here, it is 1 minus 2, that means minus 1. 1 upon minus 1, that means minus 1. So, I will write this as minus of 1 by this. So, now the factorization of xz is complete. Now, next thing, let's we have find out what is the signal xn which corresponds to xn under the condition that ROC is more than greater than 0.5. This ROC tells that signal has to be positive. Now, the expression object transform consists of two parts. This will give rise to two signals and both of them must be positive. Now, on this basis, we can write xn for part 1. Xn is 2 into one is for him.
Amen.
This is from this part. From this part, we get minus 0.5 is for n even. This you can simplify. Let's say now become 2 into even. Because 1 is for m is 1 always for any positive negative is for n, n means even. And this becomes 0.5 is for n even. You can leave like this, or if you still want, you can simplify it like this. This becomes xn. For part 1. Now for part 2, xn part 2. Let us study its ROC. ROC in this case is mod g less than 1. That means ROC is inside the inner circle. When ROC is inside the inner circle, this is that signal xn is NP coordinate. That means now both the parts. This part will also give you NP coordinate signal. This part will also give you NP coordinate signal. So, xn part, second part will be. This will give rise to NP coordinate signal. That means minus 2, 1 raised power, then we have minus n minus 1. For this part. And for this part, we have got already a minus sign here. This becomes plus 0.5 plus power n. You have minus n minus 1. Now you can simplify this. You can do it. You can take your minus n minus 1 as common from both. Now let's come to third part. For getting xn in third part, you have to be a bit careful. Let me write this ROC for you again. ROC for this part is 0.5. Mod g greater than 0.5 less than 1. Look here. In this ROC consists of two inequations. One is this. Read it out. Mod g greater than 0.5. That means this part of ROC tells that for this part signal is coordinate, because this tells the exterior of the circuit operator is 0.5. So this has to be coordinate. Now let's take, consider the ROC into the square box, which I am calling the square box. This tells mod g less than 1. That means ROC indicates inside unit circle. That means this part should lead to an NP coordinate signal. Okay. This part for coordinate signal and this part for NP coordinate signal. Now, if I try to find out, this part leads to this. This will give rise to a coordinate signal and this will lead to an NP coordinate signal. So, ROC for the third part, xn becomes, this will lead to an NP coordinate signal, that means minus 2, you have minus n minus 1, and this will lead to a coordinate signal, that means minus 0.5 raised for n given. And that completes the solution for this question. Now, determine whether the central state determine the causal signal action if this get transformed. Causal signal action is a jet transform action given by action equal to 1 plus 3g inverse 1 minus g inverse plus half here minus. In this problem, we have been given an expression for XR transform as this. Then what we have to find out? We have to find out signal XN corresponding to x under the condition that signal has to be causal. In other words, you have to find out the causal signal x to get transform because this. So for this again, we have to find out the factors for this. Xn now becomes 1 plus 3z inverse. Let's try to find out factor. It cannot be factorized directly from the quadratic equation. It's not simple factors. Factors are simple, but they are complicated. So let's solve for z inverse. But solve for z inverse. Quadratic expression, that inverse must be equal to minus b, that is 1, plus minus b square, minus 1 square, minus 4 ac half into 1 by twice a 2 into 1 by 2. So that inverse becomes inverse equal 1 plus minus 1 minus 2 divided by 1, that means 1 plus minus become minus 1 by 1, that means z inverse becomes 1 plus minus j. These are the two rules. So its factors becomes then we can write this as g inverse 1 upon 1 plus a. I am considering plus sign first. This is 1. Okay. Look here. You can write this like z inverse 1 plus a and z inverse 1 minus a. Now after this step, I am dividing by 1 by j. I get this. This can be written as 1 minus 1 by j, z inverse as one factor. Likewise, to this you can write 1 minus j, z inverse as 1. So this becomes 1 minus j, z inverse another factor is of course equal to 0. So the factors to this becomes 1 minus 1 by j, j inverse, and the other factor becomes 1 minus j, j inverse, the other factor. Now, here degree of denominator polynomial is minus 2, degree of numerator is minus 1. So, this can be again factorized, each of the two terms, 1 upon 1 by j, j inverse, 1 minus 1 minus j, j inverse, sorry. Plus 1 minus 1 upon 1 minus j inverse. Then question is, what is this numerator and what is this numerator? We have to find out this numerator. We can apply the technique of the previous problem which you have just now learned, that what is numerator. Now look here. If z inverse is 1 plus j, then this becomes 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. So let us put z inverse as 1 plus j in the rest of the expression. In the rest of the expression, what we get here is 1 plus 3 z inverse 1 plus j upon in this 1 minus 1 plus j, 1 minus j.